Okay, let's talk about Osmundo Rivero, who is, of course, claiming that he was tortured and even coerced by the police to pin Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. in your husband's killing. What do you think happened there?
I think with everything that I know, and I was given information of, I am very sure that Osmundo is not saying the truth with his second affidavit. There are a lot of loopholes there, as I have said. In fact, it can be proven that he was also involved with another murder case in Mindanao. Mm-hmm. There is an official document to prove that. And as I have said, if there are problems like that, then the quality of the information he gave on his second affidavit will really be subjected to a lot of questions.
All right. Do you think he made a bargain against his other cases?
What do you mean bargain with the other cases?
Bargain, because you said so yourself, he was facing other cases. This may be a plea in exchange for being let off the hook in those other cases. Or was he coerced?
I am not very sure if officially he is let off the hook or if there ever was a bargain that happened. But records will tell us that he was involved in a murder incident, and I think in that document that I have read, he seemed to be a part of a syndicate group, a crime syndicate group in Mindanao. So the torture thing and all other allegations of Osmundo, I think is something that we have to question as well.
All right, Mayor De Gamo, at some point in the investigation and while waiting for Congressman Teves to really face the charges, were you expecting twists like this?
I was oriented by our lawyer, actually. Our lawyer, because I get someone, a private counterpart, a private lawyer, to also explain to me the process, because I am no lawyer. Mm-hmm. And so that was part of the orientation that I have had way before the recantation. I already knew that something like this could also happen. But as I have also been made to believe, based on the facts that we have, based on the evidence that I know that we have, malabo pa rin talaga na mapapataob nila o hindi namin mapanalo ang kaso. So I am very definite. 10 people died here, and this is something that they should not play with or not take seriously. Kaya naniniwala pa rin talaga ako na sa huli we will be able to get the justice for the governor and the others who died with him.